The 38 Letters from J.D. Rockefeller to His Son. Perspectives, Ideology, and Wisdom. Written by J.D. Rockefeller. Narrated by Rick Font. Letter 1. Your starting point in life doesn't have to dictate where you end up. It's all about the actions you take and the choices you make along the way. And let's not forget the importance of influence and power. Simply having privilege or education isn't enough. We need to harness our knowledge and use it to make a difference in the world. So, let's go out there and make things happen, because we have the power to create our own destinies. July 20th, 1897. Dear John, you hope that I can sail with you forever. This sounds great, but I am not your eternal captain. God created feet for us to let us walk on our own. Maybe you are not ready to go alone, but you need to know that the challenging and magical business world that I am in is the starting point of your new life. You will start from there in order to participate in the feast of life that you have never enjoyed before, and that relates to your future. As for how you use the knives and forks that are placed in front of you, and how you taste every dish served by the angel of destiny, is entirely up to you. Of course, I expect you to stand out from the crowd in future and outdo me. However, I have decided to keep you by my side because I want to bring you to a higher starting point in life so that you can indulge in the rapid opportunities without having to face obstacles. Of course, there is nothing worth showing off or for you to feel gratified about, and you do not need to be grateful. The founding belief of the United States of America is that all human beings are created equal. But this equality is only present in the context of rights and laws. It has nothing to do with economic and cultural advantages. Think of our world as a high mountain. When our parents live at the foot of the mountain, you are destined to not live on the peak of the mountain. In most cases, the status of parents will determine the starting point of their child's life. But this does not mean that everyone has a different starting point and life outcomes. In this world, there is never a saying of inheriting wealth or poverty. Same goes to inheriting success or failure. The only truth is that as long as you work hard enough, you will succeed. I firmly believe that our destiny is determined by our actions, not by our origins. As you know, when I was young, my family was very poor. I remember that the books I read when I was in high school were bought by my kind neighbors. In the beginning of my career as a bookkeeper, I was only earning a weekly salary of $5. But it was only through unremitting efforts that have enabled me to establish an enviable oil kingdom. In the eyes of others, this may seem to be a legend, but I think it is the reward of my perseverance and hard work from the God of destiny. John, opportunities will always be unequal, but the results prove otherwise. In history, whether in politics or businesses, especially in businesses, there has been many examples of successful people who started from scratch. They have had only a few opportunities because of poverty, but they eventually achieved fame because of their past struggles. However, history has also been filled with examples of rich children who were privileged but have failed in life. According to a study that was conducted in Massachusetts on 17 wealthy people, it was revealed that none of their children left the world wealthy. A long time ago, there was a story in society that satirized the incompetence of rich children. It mentioned that in a small bar in Philadelphia, a guest was talking about a millionaire when he said, "He is a self-made millionaire." "Yeah," a smarter man next to him replied, "he inherited $20 million, but now he is only left with a million." This is a distressing story. But in our society today, the rich children are caught between advancing and retreating. Many of them are destined to be sympathetic and pitiful, and even go to hell. The glory and success of the family cannot guarantee the future of its children and grandchildren. I admit that the early advantage is really helpful, but it does not guarantee them a victory in the end. I have thought about this distressing problem for rich children more than once. I feel that once rich children begin taking advantage of their family's success, they will have little opportunity to learn and develop the skills needed for survival. People of poorer backgrounds will actively develop their creativity, abilities, while also cherishing and seizing various opportunities because they urgently need to rescue themselves. I have also observed that the kind of ambition of the rich children have often lacks the motivation and attributes the poor. Hence, they resort to praying for their own success. Therefore, when you and your sisters were very young, I deliberately concealed the fact that I was well off. I instilled many values such as frugality and personal struggle in you because I know that the quickest way to harm someone is to give them money. It can make people corrupt, depraved, arrogant, and cause them to lose their source of happiness. I cannot bury my beloved children with wealth and foolishly make you all into one that is incompetent and only depends on the success of their parents. A truly happy person is one who is able to enjoy his creation. Those of whom that are like sponges that only takes without giving will only lose happiness. I believe that there is not one person in the world that does not long for a happy and luxurious life. Yet not many people truly understand where it comes from. In my opinion, it does not come from wealthy blood, nor from a luxurious lifestyle, but from a luxurious character, the spirit of self-reliance. Only by looking at noble people who have won the respect of the world and exhibit charisma wherever they go, will we then know the worth of independence. John, every move of yours will be of concern to me. However, as compared to being concerned, I am more confident in you, and I believe in your excellent character, a character that is more valuable than any wealth in the world, that will help you pave a good future and lead a successful and fulfilling life. But you need to have the strength to believe that even though the starting point will affect the outcome, it does not determine it. Factors such as ability, attitude, character, ambition, method, experience, and luck play an extremely important role in life and the business world. Your life has just begun, but a battle of life is in front of you. I can deeply feel that you want to be the winner of this war, but you must know that everyone has the will to pursue victory, and only those who are determined and ready will win. My son, the privileged but powerless people are a waste, while the educated and unaffected people are a pile of worthless garbage. Find your own way, and God will help you. Love, your father. Letter 2. Luck isn't just something that happens by chance. It's something we can actually plan for and design ourselves. That's right. We are all the architects of our own destiny. And with the power of planning, we can make our luck work for us. It's not just about sitting around and waiting for good fortune to come our way. It's about taking action and guiding our luck towards our goals. And let's not forget the importance of individuality and creativity. We weren't meant to just march in line and follow the crowd. We have been given unique brains for a reason. So let's use them to design our own luck and create a life that we truly love. January 20th, 1900. Dear John, some people are destined to be dazzling kings or great men because of their extraordinary talents. For example, Mr. McCormick, who has a head of luck and knows how to turn a harvester into a sickle for harvesting banknotes. In my eyes, old McCormick has always been an ambitious and commercially capable industrial giant. He used harvesting machines to liberate American farmers, and he also rose to the ranks to become one of the richest persons in the United States. The French seemed to like him more and praised him to be the world's greatest contributor. Oh, this really is an unexpected reward. This business genius, who was once just an ordinary farm tool merchant, once had an esoteric saying which went, "Luck is the remnant of design." This phrase does sound quite brainy. Does it mean that luck is the result of planning and strategy? Or does it mean that luck is what remains after planning? My experience tells me that these two meanings exist. In other words, we create our own luck, and no action can eliminate it. Luck is the gospel that is difficult to get rid of in the planning process. McCormick.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.